Hello, I'm Pierre-Loup, and for this section, I'll share some details on Proton, which is used to make Steam Deck compatible with Windows games. As a little bit of background, Proton is a compatibility layer distributed through Steam. It's downloaded and set up automatically when running any game that needs it. It's made up of a collection of different open source projects, including a heavily modified distribution of Wine. It is not an emulator, meaning that your game's executable code runs as is without any modifications. However, when the app makes an API call that would normally go to an external Windows OS library, that call goes into Proton code instead. The call is then implemented using Linux APIs and open standards such as Vulkan. After a few years of development, an initial version of Proton was released to Linux users for testing in 2018. Since then, with their helpful feedback, we have been continually developing and releasing new features to improve game compatibility and performance. The effort is directly supported by Valve through our partners, our Codeweavers, as well as our own open source graphics group. The project is now at a stage where a ton of games work really well. That means they show no functional difference compared to when running on Windows. As most common APIs are already implemented and well-tested by a wide variety of existing games, it's pretty common for a new title to work perfectly out of the box without any work needed on the developer's part. That being said, the overall surface area is quite big, and there's no shortage of gaps left to cover. Running into Proton coverage issues could mean a delay before a newly released title can be enjoyed on deck. Here's some general tips on technology choices that might help avoid those gaps. We understand those are only likely to be useful for a project in early stages of planning. A good rule of thumb is that there is more room for error in Proton when the game uses massive external libraries, as opposed to code that it includes in its own build. For example, a built-in browser engine, like the Chromium embedded framework, is less likely to have issues than MSHTML. In general, we don't recommend launcher windows, but if you have one, a library such as Qt is trivial to support, unlike something like .NET WPF. For video playback, libvpx or Bink are better alternatives than Media Foundation. Complex or invasive anti-tamper or anti-cheat frameworks can be hard, or even impossible to support properly without direct involvement from their provider. Another thing that can be a huge help is for our team to be able to test and debug the game pre-release. As part of the Deck Verified program, we'll be offering tools to submit your build for pre-release testing. Such testing often allows us to uncover low-hanging fruit in time for release. As discussed today, you can also do your own testing and remote debug your application running inside the Proton environment. On the graphics side, the latest APIs, like DX11 and 12, are supported through purpose-built drivers based on Vulkan. If there is a choice between the two APIs, things are now at a point where DX12 through Proton tends to be a better experience in cases where it's also a better experience on Windows. Unlike DX12, DX11 translation is heavily reliant on dynamic shader recompilation, which can induce stutter. To address this, we have developed a robust shader pre-caching system as part of Steam. It lets all the needed permutations be processed before the game starts. This system is currently being improved for the deck, so that the processing is done on our servers ahead of time, as opposed to the user's machine. For Proton as a whole, graphics API translation also tends to be the main source of significant CPU overhead. On deck, this manifests as increased power usage, which can slightly reduce battery life, or reduce GPU-bound performance. That means that the biggest opportunity to improve Proton performance is to target Vulkan directly. It's no small task, and as such, we only recommend it in cases where it would make sense to also focus on Vulkan as your primary API for Windows. If you are using an existing engine that supports Vulkan, we recommend to enable it for your Windows build and report any performance or functional difference to your engine vendor. If your game doesn't work well in Proton, it likely means there's a bug or coverage issue on our end. We're always working to resolve those in the background, so please do report it on the developer forums. We're also working on tools to let you flag compatibility issues more directly through the partner site. If your game is already out, the Proton public bug tracker can also be a good source of information about the expected state of things, and might contain useful tips or workarounds for your reference. I hope that helps clarify how Proton functions, and how you can rely on it to target Steam Deck without a Linux version of your game. We're not talking about native Linux support today, but we'll definitely be talking more about that in the future. For now, if you have questions about Proton, let us know in the upcoming Q&A.